going too fast to prepare for this. Tripping in the world could be dangerous. Everybody circling as vultures. Negative, nepotist. Everybody waiting for the fall of man. Everybody praying for the end of times. Everybody hoping they could be the one. I was born to run, I was born for this. Will me like a race horse. Pull me like a rip. Break me down and build me up. I wanna be the slip. Put on your lip, lip. Rather than to rip, rip. Break me down and build me up. Whatever it's all. All right, good evening, everyone. We've just ticked over 7:30 p.m. here in Brisbane for our live paradigm shift follow-up phone call. So I'm sure we'll have a number of more people keep tuning in with us. Here we go. We've got a lot more people sitting in the waiting room. Let me just let everybody in. We'll try and get everyone in and then we'll get started once we've got as many people as possible fit into this Zoom room. I'm so happy that you are here tonight and that we're going to be spending the next hour together having a look at some of your paradigm shift work and homework and answering some of your questions. And I'm really, really excited that you're going to be able to hear from a few very good friends of mine, clients, colleagues, and how they've made paradigm shifts in their own lives, which is really exciting. So I'm just going to keep an eye on the waiting room for just a couple more minutes. Feel free to come on camera. That's what tonight is all about, getting to know each other and meeting other people in the community. And whether you've been with me for a while or this is your first time tuning in to a live training call that I've hosted, I'd love to see you on camera and for you to join in with us this evening. So I'll keep an eye on that waiting room. It's relatively informal tonight. You don't need another big seminar from me. You've got the paradigm shift replay there that you're working through and you've got the rest of this week. So still another week on the replay, which is fantastic. Oh, let me let Sue Taylor in. I've got to keep an eye on this waiting room and let everyone in as I go. My goodness, you're all amazing. We've got such a huge group of people tuned in tonight. And I'm just so grateful that I can be online with you and that we've been able to put together this call for you as a follow-up to your paradigm shift. So like I said, you will have another week for your paradigm shift replay. So do take advantage of that. And make sure that you spend the time, you know, going over the different sessions. I'm going to talk about some of my favorite sessions tonight as well from the last live stream. I have been doing these live stream events for 5 years and I have been working with Bob Proctor for the last nearly 5 years as one of his top three consultants based globally in the world. I also sit as regional director for the Proctor Gallagher Institute for Australia, Singapore, and New Zealand. So in addition to my own coaching and mentoring business, I also oversee an arm of our consulting division, training and developing other consultants at the same time. So you're in good hands here tonight with me and with Bob Proctor with the Paradigm Shift live stream. I've attended the event live many times. In Los Angeles, I've been on stage speaking at that event live with Bob. The only reason why I wasn't there this time was it was off the back of, I'd only got back from Toronto, Canada with Bob 10 days before, and I'm about 27 weeks pregnant with my second baby. So we're kind of getting to that line of, you probably shouldn't travel overseas anymore, Karen. So that was the only reason why I wasn't live there. And in fact, the next one in February, I will have a 4 week old. So I'll be doing that live stream with you as well. I think even, you know, my story alone of growing a global company, and having a family, a very young family, and a very big team and a very large client base is testament to the power of this material. Not a lot of people would think that's possible to be able to do that and have a very calm, very relaxed, very happy, healthy life operating at such an elite level. And that is the power of the paradigm shift material, of thinking into results, of the coaching programs, that you literally can transform your life and you can build and create exactly what you want. Now, if you had told me that 5 years ago, 10 years ago, I wouldn't have believed you. I was having a conversation with my nanny earlier today and she said, "Have you always been so calm and relaxed? Like nothing phases you, Karen." And I said, "No, not really. Like if I think back to when I had my branding and marketing company, I had a branding and marketing business that I ran for 10 years. I said, I was a relatively stressed, fairly busy person. If you got me on the phone and you said, 'How was your day, Karen?' I would have said, 'Oh, I'm so busy. Oh, I'm so stressed.' You know, I would have been looking to 8 different people for their opinion on what I should do next or how I could handle a situation. I was stuck in my own career. I remember back feeling like I was the hamster on the roller coaster, you know, pedaling so quickly, but why wasn't I getting any better results? Why was it that I wasn't performing better than I thought I could do? Because I knew I was capable of more." And I'm sure you felt like that at different times in your life where you know that you're capable of being more, of doing more, of creating more. And I'm so grateful to this day that I followed my intuition and I followed my nose and I was wise enough to invest in myself and to start working with Bob. And I didn't know then what I was getting myself in for. I had no idea where that decision would take me, but I'm so grateful that I did follow my heart and my intuition on that, against probably all better judgment and certainly the opinions of people around me, that I went for it. And we're here today because of that, in this community, being able to study this work together. So I really want to welcome you to tonight's call, and I want to encourage you to have a very, very open mind about what you can do with this material that you have and where it can take you in life and where it does end up taking you if you become a serious student of this will be far beyond what you can even imagine for yourself right now. And I say that because that is the truth. I look at some of the things that I have created in my own life in terms of relationships and family and health and travel and homes, and it was but a dream 5 years ago. And it is 100% a result of really studying and living this material that you have been exposed to over the paradigm shift weekend, of really bringing it in and integrating it into my life. So I was on a call with somebody else this morning, Aaron. I'm not sure if he's on the call tonight, but we were having a conversation. He's just started thinking into results with me, my coaching program today. And we were talking about Bob, and Verena will have some comments on this as well. Verena Lahausen, just saw him speak live in Austria as well. And I said, the thing is that one of the things that Bob has taught me is that if what you're studying does not have a spiritual component and does not connect you with universal law, then you are only working with one half of the dimension that you can create with. And most programs and most coaching don't go deep enough into the root cause of your results. And ours does. And I said to him, and he could see it, and he said, "That's what really drew me to this, because I want to go deep. You know, I want to really get serious about," and he's already earning, he's got a high six-figure company, but he said, "I really want to take things to the next level, and I know I'm capable of more." And I said, the other thing you've got to remember is Bob's 85. He's not here to prove anything to anybody, to for recognition, for status. He is just talking to you about you and telling you the truth. He's not there rah-rahing, jumping on tables. That's not him. He's just spent his whole life studying and gathering this information. And we're the beneficiaries of that through the wisdom and the organized structure of the coaching program or programs that are available to you to really, really then learn how to live this in your life. And I'm so blessed every day to be working so closely alongside him and then to be able to share that wisdom and knowledge with you as well. So again, I want to welcome you here this evening and congratulate you on making that decision to study Paradigm Shift. There, we have a few different groups of people that joined the Paradigm Shift. So I want to just acknowledge who's in the room, not only tonight, but who's in the room of our Paradigm Shift community. So there are many of you who, this is your first really big entrance into studying this or studying with Bob or even studying with me. So I can see a few names popping up there. Bianca Gannon, Caroline Daniel, welcome. Edwin Brook, Jasmine Beard, Letitia. Just looking through the list here. So Vickers. So I want to welcome you as new participants or new students to our community, to my community, and to Paradigm Shift in general. I also want to welcome clients of mine who have studied with me before. And again, we've got a couple of different groups there. So those of you who have studied thinking in my Thinking Into Results coaching or our premier 6-month coaching program, I've got a mix I can see on here and I could see with the Paradigm Shift registration list. Those of you who are currently studying, so Jane Herman, Nicole Sant, Sue Taylor, I'm looking through the list here, Des O'Neill. So I want to welcome you for being here. And it's something that I encourage all of my clients to do, to tap into Paradigm Shift to help you go deeper with what you're learning. I also want to acknowledge those clients who have done Thinking Into Results and have done Lead the Field, another coaching program of mine. And again, you've tuned in and you've tapped in. So the likes of Sarah Bascom, Ali Shepherd, who else have we got there? Let me go through the list. Tracy Anderson. Welcome, Tracy. It's great to have you on the line. Verena Lahausen is in there at the moment studying as well. So and again, that's just a tiny little snapshot in terms of who we've got in this community. So what I love about this is that it will always meet you where you're at. You'll never, ever, ever outgrow this. And I think just that cross-section of people that we have on the call tonight, connecting into this vibration, doing this work together, it's so dynamic and it's so creative. And it just goes to show that whether you have just been introduced to this 3 weeks ago or whether you've been studying with me for 5 years, that you're coming back because the material might not change, but you have changed. And so your perception and experience of what you are studying is completely different. And you're using it for completely different purposes and intentions and goals because you want to keep improving. And we know that in order to keep improving our external world and in order to keep getting better results on the outside, we have to keep improving ourselves on the inside. And that means growth spiritually, mentally, and physically. And that's what you're here to do. And I see Ali nodding her head there. So Ali, I'm going to actually go to you first and do a check-in with you because you've been studying with me for a while, but you know, how many times have you done Paradigm Shift and what drew you back to do it again this year?
Hi, Karen. I've done Paradigm Shift 3 times, I think, and The Art of Goal Achieving once. So that was earlier in the year. What brings me back? You know, it's like a reboot every time. I mean, I've studied Thinking Into Results, as you know, and that was the first program I went through with you before I then moved on to Lead the Field. But I'm a student for life of this material. Like, it actually just becomes so ingrained in a good way. And it's almost like I just need to get my fix in a way, which is I come back to paradigm shift each time, like a reboot, I suppose, is the best way of putting it. Just like a grease and oil change, I suppose. Like the car's running well, it's going well, but it's always good to get it in for a little service.
That's so true.
Check under the hood. So that's why I come back to paradigm shift. And like you said, Karen, every time I've come, I get something different. Even though I've heard the content before, that something in me has changed. I've shifted, I've grown. So my awareness has expanded. So there's probably something that I didn't pick up the first time or the second time or the third, but I go, and he's probably said it before, but I wasn't at that level of awareness where I am now. And so I just come back because there's always little gold nuggets. There's always something else and something else. And I was going to say, as a little bit of advice for those, if this was their first paradigm shift or if you've just tapping into it, what I would say is while you're in this paradigm shift bubble or this vibration, I would say make a decision, because that was one of the big things for me was decision. You know, like I would often go, oh God, I'll ask Dad, what will he think? I'll ask my friend, my best friend, what are they? But I've really learned how to not ask other people's opinions, like you said, Karen, and make decisions for myself. But while you're in this vibration and while you're tapped into the paradigm shift bubble, I would say really think about what is it that you want? What, like Bob says, what do you really want? What is it that you want? And either make a decision to go after it or get help and go after it. But albeit, just do it.
So yeah. That's such great advice. And it is, you know, I'll often, when I'm at working with Bob or with him, I'll make sure that any decisions that I need to make, I have made and executed before I get on the plane and come home.
Yeah.
Because I know how much more challenging it is once I get home and I go back into the paradigm. If I haven't already made those decisions and taken action on it, then there's a 50% chance my paradigm will want to talk me out of it by the time I land back in Australia. And you're so right in sharing that piece of advice in a week's time, in a 2 weeks time, in 3 weeks time, making that same decision will be three times as hard because you'll be back in your environment, your day-to-day environment and paradigm. And it just sucks us in and strangles all the good out of what we want to do. And
I call it a pesky little sucker.
It's so true. Hey, Ellie, can you share with everyone, like, something that's actually you've really worked on in your own life with this material? So maybe an improvement you made or a change that you made that's like a real life example of really putting this into action.
Okay, so decisions, one of the biggest things for me. And I was talking to someone recently about Thinking Into Results, your program, and they said, what have you noticed? What's been the biggest change, or what have you really noticed? And I mean, I've set some pretty big goals, and I'm still working towards those. But for me, it's been, and what I learned through the material, it's not what goals aren't to get, they are to grow. And so I've noticed how I have grown as a person. I noticed that lesson 11, the impression of increase, I think I was always being good at leaving people feeling good, but this is just now such a habit, so habitual about, you know, making sure that, and you know, if someone ticks me off, I think, oh God, I can't say something because I've got to leave them feeling good for having me. So I'm not going to say anything because I want them to feel good for having met me.
Yeah.
So decisions have been a big thing for me around being able to make a decision, commit a decisions and stick to it. The growth I've seen personally, I've made some changes in my business life, which I made a decision, I think it's about 8 weeks ago now, to move into state. And I literally thought about it. I was thinking, universe, help me out here, I need some guidance. That was on a Monday. On the Tuesday, I had a conversation with a friend and said, no, I'm doing it. And then by the Wednesday, the next week, I was moved. So, so I don't know, Karen, that's probably.
Yeah, I love that. I love that you just had the confidence within yourself to say, that's what I'm doing. And you knew how to execute it mentally.
Yeah.
Right. And to thrive through that. That's so good. We might come back to you again a little bit later, Ali. I want to go to Verena over in Austria, because you just saw Bob live. So you did a paradigm shift maybe 12 months ago. Tell us about that. So your story, Verena. So you did a paradigm shift, then you came to work with me, and now you've just seen Bob for the first time live in Austria. Share what it's been like for you.
Well, like you, I'm a mother of a now 18 months old boy. And I have turned my life into the art of bowl creation, actually. It was mid-January this year, so that's 10 months ago. And immediately there, when I saw you on the live stream, I called you and I made a decision right then and there that joined the community. I started with TIR. I'm now working with a game changer. I came out of maternity leave as a self-employed, creating my own business opportunities.
Verena, your internet's dropping out. Is it dropping out for everyone else?
When I do it, I'm sorry. May you come back to me and I fix this in the meantime?
Yeah. That sounds good. We're going to come back to Verena because her story is really good. Verena's also a human rights lawyer. So let's just, she is this incredibly skilled, talented woman who is doing just very cool things, but really tapping into and developing her gifts. There's other things, other goals, which are just, she's writing a book. And I just want to make sure that we get her to share with you how she's used this in her own life over the last 10 months. Simone Bertram, let's go to you. You're a bit of a junkie for these paradigm shift events and this material. How many have you now done and why do you keep coming back?
I'm pretty sure I'm at 4. And Ali, thanks for the reminder. I've also done the Art of Goal Creation as well. Yeah, I forgot about that one. The reason why I keep coming back, yes, a bit of a junkie. I'm addicted to this material. And let's face it, who doesn't want to spend 2.5 days, literally or virtually, in the room with Bob Proctor and Sandy Gallagher? Ali's touched on a lot of things that I think all of us that have been repeatedly attending these, getting more, your awareness grows, things stand out a little bit more. You're like, I've heard this before, but it didn't resonate. So definitely I'm wanting to gain more through this. And it was only sort of this year that I understood, what's it called, the forgetting curve. And it's, what's the percentages? The forgetting curve is after a week, you forget 90% of something that you've actually learned recently. So through the power of repetition, and look, I've come from radio, I know a new song, it takes many times before you understand the words. But through the power of repetition, that's when the things start to stick and resonate and get into the subconscious mind, where that elephant that's sitting in the subconscious mind that doesn't want to move, you're slowly chipping away at it and going, hey, hang on, it's time to move. Come along the journey with me. We want to make a change, so get on board. I'll continue doing paradigm shifts because I'm just, every time I'm getting a shift closer and closer to where I want to be, definitely.
Mm. And, you know, you're not only just tapping into this every 3 months when, you know, Bob does a paradigm shift, like you're engaged in studying this every day. What have you, share with us an example, particularly for those who might be new to this, where you have really created an improvement or a change, like a real life example of applying this material to your life?
So 3 years ago in August is when we launched together, Karen, with Thinking Into Results and studying this program. And it's probably been the last 2 years where I've gone, you know what, this material really works. And I've put it to practice over and over again. There's been many times I've hit the terror barrier and making decisions.
So just tell everyone what the terror barrier is like, because not everyone will understand.
It's sickening. It's exciting to start with, because you have this amazing idea or something that in the pit of your stomach you actually really want. And the thought of it, you absolutely love, but trying to action it absolutely makes you sick. So, you know, you've got this this X idea. Sorry if I'm getting it mixed up. The X idea, but then the Y idea, it sort of is clouding the judgment, and then you're almost there, and then something happens and you stop and you go, I can't do this. I'm just going to go back to what I actually know because I'm quite comfortable and I'm safe and I'm happy and I don't have this sick feeling. But then you go back into bondage and you're like, I'm not happy here. That's why I want to change. So by getting past that terror barrier, and Karen helped me this, when was it? Probably 12, 18 months ago, I was asked to present the Tunarama Gala Awards night. And when I got asked, it's something I really wanted to do. As soon as I said yes, I felt sick. And I went, oh my God, I've committed to this, but it's what I want. But can I do it? How am I going to do it? And I went, no, I'm going to do this. So I went over terror barrier lesson over and over and visualized, did everything. And then the day of I was going to do it, they actually said how many politicians were going to be in the room. Again, bang, straight in that terror barrier again. And I went, you know what? What's the worst thing that can happen? I can mumble my words, just make it lighthearted. Talk to the light of the room, Karen said to me. And I tell you what, it was one of the most amazing nights that I'd experienced in growth, but also in recognition to go, well, this is something I want to work towards. I want to be able to present. And they reckon public speaking, people would rather catch on fire than do public speaking in front of a room full of people. So, you know, when you can get a goal that you love so much in your stomach that you want to do, and then when you achieve it, you almost go, what's next? What else am I capable of? What else can I do? And when you have that feeling, nothing, no, there's no money attached to it. There's nothing else that compares to it. I've got many stories because of this material. I don't want to take
tell us about, I know, and we're sharing these are quite personal, but I love your story about the Bon Jovi concert. Was it Bon Jovi? And how there were no tickets left and you applied what I had taught you and you got yourself backstage passes to Bon Jovi. Just give us the short version of that because that's cool.
The short story, I should have spoke about this one first. Lifelong goal from what, if anybody's a Bon Jovi fan in this group, you're going to know, okay, who doesn't want to cuddle John Bon Jovi? So 5 years ago, I had made a committed decision that next time they come to Australia, I am going to have a photo with Bon Jovi. I'm going to meet the whole band. I don't know how, but it's exactly what's going to happen. So to narrow it down, I thought I'd done all the right steps through the fan club. I joined everything to make sure I get all the notifications. I missed it. I absolutely missed it. And my girlfriend said, did you get the opportunity? And I said, well, when? When did it happen? She said, well, this is the hour. And I'd actually been flying when it happened. So I went, no, this isn't enough. I'm still going to meet him somehow. And my friends are saying, buy normal tickets. Just go to the concert. I'm like, I've done that. I'd rather not go to the concert at all. This is what I'm doing. So putting TIR, putting into the vibration, I photoshopped myself next to John Bon Jovi. My husband thought I was losing the plot. Spoke to my dad about it as well and said, look, I need help financially. This is actually going to happen. He thought I was going through a midlife crisis. It's what I wanted, Dad. This is exactly what I want. I am not going to go to my grave without this number one goal of mine or before he actually dies. I'm going to have it. And sure enough, with all the wills of my mind and the belief in the system, I got an email from the manager of Bon Jovi to say, Simone, we've got you a ticket. You're coming to Sydney and you will spend 2.5 days with the band.
Of course, because that is the law.
And that's exactly what I wanted and I got it.
Yeah. And you know what? Isn't it so good? And what I love about it, when we ask for what we want and we get into harmony with it, like it's so easy.
It was so easy. I literally borrowed that myself and the girl in the next office, she goes, I can't believe that happened. I said, well, I actually can. She said, it's exactly what you said you wanted. And I went, and then I started talking about TIR. She's like, what?
Yeah, I love it. That's so good. All right, Simone, leave us with one tip, one takeaway for everyone listening tonight or that might catch this recording. Like, how can they maximize their paradigm shift experience?
That's a big question, Karen.
I know, but I'm about big ideas, Simone.
Yeah.
So.
I would definitely say about making a decision and sticking with it, because what's going to happen after a week or so, you know, when we don't have the access to the replay and life starts just getting back into normality, we're going to lose that traction that we had, that great vibration, that willingness of going, this is what I want to do and this is when I want to do it by. So write it down crystal clear, word for word, write it big, write it 100 times, have it everywhere in your house. This is what I'll do. Don't worry about sharing it with your friends or your family because they're not going to understand what it is that you've made a decision on. They're going to think you're a little bit, you know, because they haven't done the paradigm shift. But do it for yourself, honestly, because when you do everything for yourself first and foremost, it just radiates out to the family, to your friends, to everybody that you know, that you're fulfilling what it is that you truly desire. And by neglecting yourself and doing that, the only person that's hurting is yourself.
Mm. 100% well said. I love that. Thank you, Simone. Let's go back to Verena because hopefully Verena's internet's working. Let's try you again, Verena. Can we?
Yes. Hi again.
Hi. That's way better. Okay. Great. So tell us. So you did Art of Goal Creation, saw me on stage at that event, and tell us about some of the changes that you've made in the last 10 months in your life.
I don't know what I haven't changed, really, other than my apartment. I'm still sitting in my living room in my two-bedroom apartment because I couldn't find anything that is nice enough to move to. But everything from my use of time, my income from zero to, you know, whatever it'll be at the end of the year, I contacted the number one expert in my field in New York. It was the most random, you know, outrageously bold thing for me to do. And he was here already working with me. Came to visit from New York. We are creating an international mediation tour next year through the Arab world, through Europe. I 10 weeks after I started TIR, I was asked to put my C-type goal into practice, and that was even too early for me. It was in a huge tariff area. So it was 10 weeks after having started to, you know, put my C-type goal, which is creating an international peace and leadership academy, to put that into action. And I thought, like, it cannot be that easy. Like Simone just said, that it's so easy. And the crazier your dream, the crazier your idea, probably the easier it is somehow. Mm-hmm. That's what I want to say. What you said, Karen, about me going from Art of Goal Creation early this year to meeting Bob last Saturday in Vienna, actually meeting him face to face. There's pictures that were taken to prove it, otherwise I might still not believe it is. I was visualizing 3 months ago, I think, meeting Bob, and I thought that this would happen in the consultant training in Toronto, but somehow that didn't happen because I was pulled away for an assignment. And then I thought, well, that's interesting. I still think I'm gonna meet Bob at some point soon, but it's probably not gonna happen this year anymore, right? I mean, I was traveling, I will be still traveling again. I have a small kid. I'm not gonna travel to wherever he is in the North American hemisphere. So that's disappointing. So that's one visualization that hasn't gone to fruition. And then you call me up, Karen, and you say, well, listen, Bob is gonna be in Vienna in 2 weeks time. And I said, what, when? And so I haven't even had to travel there because I was already there for business. So all I had to do was travel through town, 20 minutes, to meet Bob in person. And I was thinking, well, that's really, it's so easy. And if I hadn't a picture to prove it, I still wouldn't believe.
And I want to preface the part of this story so everyone else knows. So I didn't know that Verena has been visualizing this. So yes. Verena's a client of mine, has been since the start of the year. She lives in Graz, Austria. And so I'm getting out the map of Austria and I'm looking up where she lives and I'm looking up and I'm like, I think that's quite close. and so I'm thinking, well, you know, I've got other clients in Austria as well. And I'm thinking, well, you could all go to this event with Bob. So I just call Verena and I'm like, Bob's going to be in Vienna in 2 weeks. Can you get there? Because you should go and we should take all of our clients and anyone else that wants to work with me in Germany or Europe, and we'll invite them all to Vienna to go to this event with Bob. And I didn't know that she had been visualizing this and thinking to herself, this isn't going to happen. But that's the way it works. Once you declare what you want, everything that has to come together to support you does. And that's how that happened. And it was so cool, wasn't it, Verena?
It was fantastic. And it's interesting when you're sitting there live, you pick up, like Ellie said, you pick up different things. It's, I've written down 5 pages of notes that I've never taken in after 3 rounds of paradigm shift and doing TIR for 2 rounds almost now. I've written down things that I have never picked up on, just because in the live energy of things, it's again, you are on a different playing field at all. So it's very, again, it's a change in vibration after having been there to meet, to meet the big man.
Yeah. And you've got a book coming out, you're writing a book as well. So you, when's that going to launch, or how, like, what's that book on? Cause that's new in the last 10 months as well, really getting this book together. Tell us a little bit about that.
You're asking me, your question only brings out the tarot barrier huge.
I know.
So I'm glad that I have my mastermind partner, Benita, on the line here and looking at her while I'm talking. The book is going to be on conflict, culture, and leadership. And I had this crazy idea on a plane to Frankfurt, and I will have to put it into action by the end of the year. So launch should be January next year. Now, hold me to it now that I said it out loud.
It's out there, it's declared, and everyone on this call will support you in launching that. I know it. All right, so give everyone one little tip. So you have done outer goal creation, you've done thinking into results, you've seen Bob live. Like, what is your piece of guidance or wisdom to help another person on this call really maximize their experience?
You know what I think, and I thought this to, I thought this just now also, follow the impulse, follow the most crazy impulse that gives you butterflies in your stomach coming out of the paradigm shift, and follow your impulse right away. Follow your impulse to act, and to get help, to make this phone call, to get enrolled into the coaching, to, you know, to do whatever your impulse tells you to do within the next 72 hours, or else you're not going to do it anymore. And the crazier your impulse, and the crazier your dream behind it, and the more it makes you laugh at yourself, the more you need to follow your impulse right away, because that's when the magic starts happening. And it's so much easier than we think it ever will be. It's just actually the easiest if you actually act, follow that impulse.
Totally. That's so good. Well, let's go to your mastermind buddy, Benita Bench, because she's sitting there all lovely. Imagine this. So Verena is sitting in Graz, Austria, and Benita is sitting on a cattle and cropping farm in regional and rural Australia, and they are working together through this coaching. Like, this is what is so cool about my community, I'm going to say it, like the people that we've got here, that you two are on opposite sides of the world. You're both mums, you're writing books, you are doing extraordinary things in your respective fields, and you can be studying and working together in this way. Isn't that amazing, Benita?
It is amazing, Karen, and I still get off my calls from Verena and walk back into the lounge room to my husband and go, I've just been talking to my friend in Austria. It does still blow my mind that we can be in this international community simply by pressing a button on the computer. It's pretty special.
Yeah. So tell us, so you, you've also got a really interesting story from when you, I remember when you first reached out to me and you got involved in studying this and the transformation to now. Give us a little bit of an insight. I feel like it's a bit of a sliding doors for you, like this, there was one Benita and now there's another Benita. What does it feel like that for you? It looks like that from me watching the transformation.
Yeah, it does feel like that, Karen. there's still, so I guess to paint a picture of the old Bonita, which was actually nearly 12 months ago to the day, on the 30th of October last year, the old Bonita was in a pretty bad way, sitting on the floor in the kitchen surrounded by groceries with four children. This is at 5 p.m. with four children under four to feed and get to bed, and a team of men who were harvesting our crops to feed dinner and to put all the groceries away and to keep ticking along. And as a mum to four young children in a farming situation, I'd had basically 3 years of being in survival mode where I'd invested nothing in myself, and it showed. I got to that point where I was a mess. I was still high functioning from the outside looking in, but internally I was in chaos. I was totally ridden with anxiety to the point where I couldn't hardly make a decision. And I knew, you know, I called you 7 days later, and I'd been watching you on Facebook for 6 months, but you know, the paradigm was saying, you haven't got enough time to study, you haven't got enough money, you can't do that. But I knew in my heart that that's what I wanted. And after I hit the wall, as I call it, 7 days later, I said, I've got to do this. I have to do this. And that was the beginning. And I was looking back through my notes, actually, from my first discovery call. And that was the beginning of the paradigm shift for me, filling out that form. I look back at that now and I go, wow. And filling out that form showed me that there was a lot I wanted to change. And that was the beginning of just the excitement of, oh, my goodness, what do I want? I can go after it, and I've got someone to help me do that. So a bit like Verena, what haven't I changed in the last 12 months? And it's been an uncomfortable ride at times, but it's been phenomenal. And yeah, I could mention a lot of things, but probably for me, decision is another one, same as you, Ali. That's been a big thing for me, recognizing that I wasn't a good decision maker and trusting myself enough to make better decisions, and also changing my attitude to an I can attitude, not an I can't attitude, because I'd become so ingrained in this headspace of everything is so hard, I can't do that, I don't have time, I'm too busy, I'm not allowed to do that, you know, I'm a mum, how could I possibly want to do that, you know, it just that's been the biggest shift, is to go, I can do that. How can I make that work? So I've changed a lot of behaviors, a lot of habits, achieved a lot of things. It's still a work in progress, that's for sure, every single day.
Well, I think it always is. But yeah, the work in progress gets to be able to be done from a higher state of consciousness.
Yes. And to be able to stop yourself in those moments of anxiety or overwhelm and go, okay, I have tools, I have a system, instead of that free fall. And I know I've got a point of support, and it's in here, but it's also a community, and it's also TIR is my system.
Yeah. That's so awesome. And tell us, so your book is coming out on the 20th of November. So
yeah,
over a month. Tell us about that book that you wrote, or you'd obviously started to develop it pre-working with me, or did it all come together as part of the last 12 months where you're like, right, I'm going to write this book, I'm going to get it done, and 12 months later it's about to come out on the shelf. So just give us a little insight into what that book's about.
Okay, yeah. So the book's been a seed, in seed form for a long, long time. The book is basically about my journey to create our family. So we had a challenging time conceiving our children, and not all of them, but three of them. And through those 7 years, I kept a journal. And as time went on, I couldn't shake the feeling that there was power in what I had recorded, and that I wanted to collate it and capture the story as a healing process for me, for our children and also to support other people. And it was very much a stop-start affair over 5 years probably. And when I joined TIR in lesson one in goal setting within 2 weeks, I decided, committed decision, I'm going to write this book and I'm going to get it finished by next September. So I didn't meet the September deadline, but the 20th of November, it will be.
Hang on, you only missed it by 2 months. That's a pretty good guess when you look at the law of gestation, how long it's going to take you to do something.
So without this course, I don't know if it ever would have come to light, or if it would have. It, in my vision, I was going to get a local graphic designer to design it and maybe get a few copies printed and hand it out to a few people and go, job done. But now it's going to be on for sale online around the world. So,
Yeah, I know. And I had said to Benita when we were talking about getting this published, and I said, I have a publisher in the US. You need to go to the publisher in the US with this. This is not a just publish it local book. And Benita's like, what? And I'm like, yes, I'm going to introduce you today and you're going to use this publisher in the US to publish your book, which she is now doing, and it will be an international bestseller. So do you want to share with us the title of it so we can all keep an eye out for it on the 20th of November?
Sure. It's called The Art of Trying. And here's the, that's what it looks like.
There you go. Benita
Betts. Congratulations. It's called The Art of Trying. And I've been in the Tarot Barrow pretty much for 12 months writing it. But I keep pushing through thanks to you all.
That's good. Well, we love that. What's your one little tip that you want to share with everyone to really maximize what they've learned so far?
Out of paradigm shift. I would say just keep out of paradigm shift. I would say what the other girl said, you have to take action straight away. So like all the impulses that Verena was describing. So for me, when I'm doing the paradigm shift, it's like lightning bolts, idea, do this, I should do that. Really you have to capture it. You have to put it into an action plan, put a date on it. When am I going to do it? How am I going to do it? Because otherwise it just stays in your workbook. And if you're not a client of Karen's, book a discovery call. That's the next one.
Yeah, absolutely. Napoleon Hill says in Think and Grow Rich, failure to act on the good ideas your mind gives you will be futile to your success. And that's exactly what you've summed up, that it's there, the way is being shown. It can be that easy, but if you don't act on it, then it's no good to you. Nothing's going to change. So...
thanks, Karen.
Awesome. I love that. Thank you, Benita. I've got a couple more people that I want to have a chat to, Sarah Bascom. Before I do that, we have touched a little bit on decision, and I think that's probably the most important theme that you will have heard Bob talk about and you will have heard us talk about. And it's truly something that you've got to understand, that all of these goals and dreams and changes you want to make and improvements you want to make, nothing can occur until you've made that committed decision and you've flipped your mind. A hope or a wish is not going to cut it. You will not get the money. You will not create the time. You will not find the right people to help you until you've made the decision. And as Bob says, that the only prerequisite to making a decision is, do you want it? That's it. Everything else you will figure out on the other side of it. And you are smart and clever and of sound and wise mind. You will figure out a way, but you've got to make that decision first. And I think that's a really, really important takeaway. And what everyone has said, making those decisions now, right now, not giving your paradigm or circumstances or anything another breath of air to influence the course of your life. Follow that quiet voice within and you will do things and create things that you could never have imagined. And doing it in this environment, doing it off the back of tonight's call, doing it in the next 24 hours while you are in this space, it still might be scary and it might not be logical to you to do it, but it'll be so much easier to do it now. You are kidding yourself You are telling yourself a brutal lie if you think that it's going to be easier to make this decision in 2 weeks or a month or 3 months' time. It just ain't going to happen. So you have to just make that decision and act on it now while you're in this space. Sarah Bascom, are you there? Are you still there, Sarah?
Hi, Karen. Yes, I am.
Hello. Great. So I want to introduce everyone to Sarah Bascom. Sarah and I have been working together for a few years now. And I was doing a similar time when I think I already knew Simone. I was already working with Simone, but I was down in South Australia and I was doing a series of events, and Sarah and her husband run a very large dealership, machinery dealership, in a little town called Cummins on the Eyre Peninsula in South Australia. And I was doing a little local event there, a talk in the local hotel, and Sarah had no idea who I was or that I worked with Bob Proctor. She was like running late, you know, I don't have time to go. And I think it was Alana, one of your daughters, was like, you've got to go to that, mum. And she had no idea what she was walking into. And the rest is history, as they say, Sarah. And you've done Paradigm Shift a few times and you've done all of my coaching. What is your wisdom to share on Paradigm Shift as a serious student of this, that you've been around, you're in our community? What can you share with everyone tonight that will really help them maximize this experience?
Yeah, I guess first of all, really trusting that quiet voice from within. Sorry, excuse me. And I think that's what led me initially, Karen, to I was sent an invitation to your event, and I had actually been looking up all PGI's programs. I'd previously done 6 Minutes to Success, and I wanted something else. And a bit like Benita, I wasn't in a very good space at all. And I knew that it was up to me to do something about it. And so just basically I had that desire within me to find something, and I kept looking, and then to just accept that invitation. And like you said, you know, everything seemed to be going against me. I was running late. I had so much to do when I got home, but it all just seemed to flow. And I think as soon as I accepted and I just let, then I can look back and I can see how it unfolded. But, you know, I know the one of the biggest things you said leading into that event was, you know, don't be late. And so I knew that it was like, far out, I'm going to rock up to this event and I'm going to be late, and she's going to be, you know, and I walked in just as you were about to start, and it was, the fear inside of me was incredible. Just to even step into that room was a terror barrier moment for me. And I walked in and there was not a seat in sight, and I felt like a fish out of water. And a lady I'd worked with previously said, Sarah, come and sit here. And I was just like, oh, thank goodness somebody's kind enough, you know. And I sat down, and as soon as she started speaking, I thought, oh, well, of course. Of course someone who worked so closely with Bob is in my hometown. And I think I just knew, like in that instant, I just knew I have to work with you. Like, and it just gives me goosebumps now even remembering that moment, because, you know, one of the things you said is that you'll need a telescope to look back. And I was like, oh yeah, you know, but literally I am a completely different person now to that person sitting in that room. And it is testament to this material and the daily study and application of it, because, you know, starting out, I wouldn't even get on these, like I wouldn't even turn my camera on. I would never put my hand up to interact on these webinars. And here I am now sitting on here just comfortably doing it, and have even having had the opportunity to support you on Zoom and webinars, Karen, when you haven't been able to be there, is just the paradigm shifts just keep coming, and they're endless. So it really is like, listen to that quiet voice within, because that is your spirit seeking expression. And you can, there's so many defining moments that we all face, and you can either act on them or you can let them go. And you never know the significance of those little moments unless you do act on them. So, yeah, that's my little bit there.
That's so powerful. And you, you and your husband, you built a house that you didn't know when you wanted to build this house, but you had no idea where the money or the resources would come from. And I remember you talking to me about it, and you're like, I have no idea, Karen, like it's going to cost this amount of money. Like, we're not there yet. And I said, get it on your goal card, get the plans drawn up, the way will be shown. And you're living in that house now, and you've built like a whole equestrian arena for your kids, and it's amazing. Just give us a little snapshot into that paradigm shift.
Yeah, sure. It wasn't that long after, like it was literally, I signed up in the March, I'm pretty sure, might have been February, March, I'm not sure. But within that first couple of weeks, definitely the first 30 days, the confidence that I felt was incredible. You know, I went from not wanting to travel generally, like with my kids on my own, to driving over 700 kilometres with, you know, my two daughters, two ponies on my own, to a horse show that we had never competed at that level before, completely just, you know, and I would never have done that previously. To then, you know, we'd had owned our block of land for probably 10 years and had always just talked about it. You know, oh, one day we'll do this, one day we'll do that. Oh, the business needs the money here. And, you know, like never making that committed decision. And then we'd done some plans, and we had money for a deposit and all of that. And we had thought we had enough equity to get our loan from the bank to complete the home. And so my husband, in his wisdom, thank him, you know, opens the gates. Yep, we'll pour the slab, it's going ahead. And then we talk to the bank and we discover, we're like nearly $100,000 short. And it was seriously, that is the biggest terror barrier I have ever been in my life. I was literally shaking. The anxiety was all consuming. I felt violently ill. And it was like all of a sudden the grit came in, and it was like, I'll be damned if this is going to have me. You know, it's either we pull the pin and we have some concrete on the ground and nothing else and no money, or we just go, it's happening. And I think within a week, we had the money.
Yeah.
And it was literally, it was, you know, that decision. And it's really hard to get your head around the how much that impacts what happens to you and how it comes into your life. But it is literally like opening the door. You open the door and it can then flow. And I said to my husband, I said, we need this much money. Otherwise, you know, and within a week, we had worked out, yep, ideas came and it was just bang, bang, bang. Decisions made. Exactly. And, you know, we're in the house and, you know, and it is still a work in progress. But you just learn how to make the decision so that things will unfold. And, you know, we're still in the processes of doing different things on our property. But, yeah, it's like I wanted to create this amazing space for my family and my kids and myself to enjoy. And, what better place to do it than where you live?
It's such a great example when Bob teaches, and when you've heard me teach, when you make that committed decision and you fuse with the vibration of what you want, you fuse with the image. And we know thoughts are energy. So as you're holding this picture of what it is that you want, it has to happen by law, because you're now tapped into that vibrational point of attraction. And so what's happened is you've become a conscious competent. You knew through the study that you had done with me what to do in that moment. And you're absolutely right. You could have, if that hadn't have been a committed decision and you'd already poured the slab, your paradigm in that moment, that terror barrier, would have given you every possible logical argument as to why it could not happen. But you were wise enough in that moment to know, with based on what you had learned and experienced, that I actually have to go all in deeper than I ever have before to trigger the law in my favor to bring me what I want. And it wouldn't, I'm sure it wasn't that comfortable at all to do that, but you now have that experience. And that's what I love, you know, I want, when we look at the faculty of memory, that you have that experience now. So next time, because you've done this so many times now, Sarah, where, you know, you've held the image, you see it happening, you've created it, you've moved into harmony to receive, taken action to get it. The next time you go to set your next C-type goal, you have this memory, these experiences to help you build belief. That, because it's the same process. It does, it's just the subconscious mind cannot tell what's big or small. It's just a different image. And the more you come to understand that, the more powerful you realize you are in creating the reality, the kingdom that you want to live in, because it's all images and it's just understanding exactly how to use your mind properly in an orderly way. Not a hit and miss basis. You got to know A comes before B comes before C. Like, you got to do things in a certain way. And then you invoke the law to make it really easy for yourself. And I mean, that's such a cool story that you, can you imagine just a concrete slab of a house on a block of dirt?
Yeah. Like, I know, you know, Karen, like, coming to that confidence and, you know, and it comes from having that plan that you speak about and knowing that, you know, that definiteness of where you're going and that you have the support. And I think accountability and support, there's a lot of people that are achieving great things and that's wonderful. But I think there's so much more. And, you know, I think we're just conditioned to not, you know, to be happy with what we have. And I think, and that's, you know, be very grateful, but it is only through expansion of ourselves that we can be of greater service to others. And I think, you know, I know with our business going to that next level, it just means so much more for so many more people around us, not just us individually, but on such a bigger scale. And, you know, there's nothing to be ashamed of wanting more either, because I think, you know, we are so conditioned to just, oh, you know, you've got to be happy with what you got, don't want too much, and yeah, stay safe and stay small and all of that. But yeah, it's so good. So
That's amazing. So I want to share with everyone, I'm going to come back and ask you for your piece of wisdom in a minute, Sarah, to share with everyone. But I know that we have, like I said at the beginning, varying people with at different levels on this call. So I wanted to give you some really clear next steps depending on where you're at. So we have probably three groups of people that are tuned in, not only live on the call tonight, but tapped into Paradigm Shift. So there's going to be those of you, Bianca, Caroline, Mel, Jasmine, who this is your first sort of entry point. You've done Paradigm Shift. You've just started to become part of my community. If you're in that boat of that group of people, then I would recommend that you study thinking into results as your first step. It is a phenomenal foundation, and it's the TIR that you've heard everyone refer to on tonight's call. And so what I want to do, for if you're in that group where you haven't done thinking into results with me yet and you need to make a decision out of Paradigm Shift, I want to encourage you to make a decision and get yourself enrolled in thinking into results within the next 24 hours. Now, we know that people who make decisions quickly are the big winners in life. So I really want to reward those of you who are going to have the courage to take action, even though it might seem scary and be a little illogical. And I'm going to add some extra things into your program, your coaching for you at no extra cost to you. So I'm going to give you 9 months in the coaching program for the price of six. And I'm going to invite you to participate in a business mastermind with me, a business mastery mastermind. It's a brand new opportunity for you. And you're going to meet with me once a month for 60 minutes. And I'm really going to take you to the next level. I'm going to, if it's your income you want to work on, if it's your sales, if it's your personal growth, it's a mastery mastermind. And so for the first 10 people within the next 24 hours who act on that, you're going to have access to 9 months for the price of six. So an extra 3 months in that coaching program, plus access to 6 business mastery calls with me like this, going deep on your goals, working on your ideas, working in your business with you, and tapping into a vibration of people like this. So that's what I want to offer you tonight, for taking action and not letting that paradigm stop you any way, shape, or form. I'm going to pop the link in the chat. So those of you who are in that category, that is your link. That'll take you direct to the Thinking Into Results enrollment form. And you can take the in-full option, the payment plan option. Either one is fine. As long as you act on it within the next 24 hours, you're going to get the extra 3 months and the 6 business mastery calls with me. You and I are going to work together for 6 months as an added mastermind level. Those of you who have done Thinking Into Results with me, but you are yet to complete the new Lead the Field coaching program, I want to encourage that as your next step. You are going to go deeper with what you have learned with Thinking Into Results. You are going to tap into the Lead the Field study mastermind with me every 2 weeks. You're going to really look at strategic business thinking in your business. We're going to really expand your self-image and your self-worth. When I moved into the new Lead the Field coaching, my own self, it was like spinning my head around and putting it back on. And I already had a pretty healthy self-image and self-worth, but Lead the Field took me to a whole new level. It's a 4-month intensive coaching program. And for you, the first 10 of you who fit into that category, you've done Thinking Into Results with me, but you haven't done Lead the Field yet, you are going to get an additional, 6 months for the price of 4. So a whole 6 months in that coaching program with me. And you will also get access to the Business Mastery Mastermind. So I'm putting together a curated group of people, those action takers who are taking action within the next 24 hours and getting into these next steps of coaching. I'm going to be working with you for another 6 months as well, once a month on that business mastery call, going deeper with your goals, your business goals, bringing you to that high 6 figures per year. If you have an income goal and you're not high 6 figures, I want to get you there within the next 6 months. If you're already there, then I want you to go over the 7 figures within the next 6 months. If that is part of your income goal, we can do some work on the business mastery calls around that, and I can teach you how to do that. If it's earning more but working half as much, I worked with someone this morning who wants to do that. He wants to earn $500,000 a year but work 2 to 3 days a week. So I'm going to teach him how to do that. So again, if you're in the new Lead the Field coaching program, for no extra cost, you're going to get 6 months for the price of 4, plus access to those 6 business mastery calls, mastery mastermind, connecting in with a community like this at no extra cost to you. So I am going to put the Lead the Field enrollment link in the link. If you fit in that category, you can click this link. And again, you can go ahead, fill out the form, take the in-full or the payment plan price, doesn't matter, as long as you take action on it. And we're going to get you started in the Lead the Field. If you fit into the category where you have done both of those coaching programs with me already, and you're looking for your next level, and you should be looking for your next level, as we have very clearly discussed tonight, there is no end to your growth and where you can go next. And I want to invite you to join my Inner Circle of Excellence program. Now, this is an elite level 6-month coaching program, and we're going to meet 3 times a month and really go very, very deep into the study of this material. And I'm going to show you how to make a huge quantum leap And again, I'm going to give you 9 months for the price of 6 for the first 10 people who fit into that category and act on it within the next 24 hours. And you will also have access to the Business Mastery Mastermind calls with me. So again, this is a curated group of people. We want action takers. We want decision makers. And I want to put you in an environment where from all of the different levels that you're at, you're connecting and creating together. And I'm going to be facilitating that 60 minutes, maybe even 90 minutes. Sometimes it'll go longer. That Business Mastery Mastermind with you once a month. We're going to do 6 calls, 6 months. That's in addition to your standard coaching program that you're all getting the extra time in those coaching programs at no extra cost to you, plus that Business Mastery. So again, if you have studied everything there is to study with me, there's something else you haven't done yet, the new Inner Circle of Excellence program. So you're going to be in my inner circle studying that coaching program with me for the next 9 months. And this is the perfect opportunity, whether you're moving into thinking into results, lead the field, the Inner Circle program. We have 2 months before the end of the year. In 2 months, what I can do with you will blow your mind at whatever level you're coming in. So make the decision now. It's the middle of October. The runs that we can get on the board for you now, setting you up between now and Christmas to accomplish some really big goals to springboard you into 2020, the next decade. Like, what do you want to accomplish in the next decade? This is what we can work on and really, really take you to that next level. So the Inner Circle of Excellence program, there is no link for you to sign up here. You need to email me and the first 10 people, I'll talk to you tomorrow about it and we can get you set up into that coaching program. So that opportunity for those extra bonuses will be open for 10 people in each of the coaching programs. So 10 into Lead the Field, 10 into Thinking into Results, and 10 into the Inner Circle program. How does that sound? Is that a good outcome for Paradigm Shift? I think that's going to help a lot of people shift. I'm so excited about it. And I totally just worked with spirit on that. This was not something that I was going to offer tonight. And I woke up this morning and I thought, we got to do more. I want to do more with you and I want to help you create at a higher level. And I just let the ideas flow today. And spirit said, this is what you need to do. This is what you need to give them. And so that's what I'm giving you at no extra cost to you to be able to access the extra training and the Business Mastery calls with me for the next 6 months, which is really exciting. I can't wait to be working with you. All right. So, Sarah, what is your one little takeaway that you want to impart on everyone, the wisdom that you want to share with everyone finishing up tonight?
One little takeaway, do what Karen says.
I didn't pay her to say that.
I actually had wrote this down previously, Karen, so it's quite amazing that I get to do this now. But it's kind of one of the biggest things that I remember that you've said to me is that each time you don't honor spirit, you are chipping away at your self-confidence and self-worth. And so each time you choose the paradigm over spirit, you are chipping away at your self-confidence and self-worth. And it's so true. And you might not realize it initially, but it's like that grape in the bunch of grapes that has that bit of mold on it. And it slowly starts to filtrate through all of the rest of them. And before you know it, it starts to impact so many different areas of your life. And you can't actually pinpoint the one thing that created all of this disharmony and dis-ease, you know, that you feel. And that's not to say that your life's bad or that but it's a feeling within. And I think, you know, there's so many defining moments that we come up against, and it's, are you going to choose to take it and act on it, or are you going to choose to let it be?
Beautifully said. That old self-esteem ladder, we can lift ourselves up on it by following the quiet voice within and really going after what we want, or we can knock ourselves down. by honoring the paradigm. Well said, Sarah. I'm so grateful to you. I'm so grateful to all of our guest speakers tonight who have shared their stories with you. I'm honored to hear your sharing of those stories and to be a co-creator with you. You have done this. You're the ones that are creating this reality for yourself. And even those of you that we didn't bring on the line tonight, I know you have stories just like this. Janet Blair, Jane Herman, Catherine Maggs, Melanie Raymond, Peter McIntyre, Sally Porteous, Tracy Anderson, Sue Taylor, the courage that, you know, you took in taking the next step. You know, there are just, this is the tip of the iceberg. And I just feel so honored and I'm so grateful to you, those of you that have shared tonight, for sharing so openly and honestly with everybody, and knowing that this is going to be listened and the recording will go out to more people that have tuned into Paradigm Shift, and that in this moment, this blessed moment that we've had together tonight, that you are going to change another person's life, because someone else will listen to this and will hear this recording and they will be changed forever by hearing your story. And I am so passionate about that, that we are about real people, real results. And I want to trigger a response in you to move forward on that goal or dream and be willing to invest in yourself, invest in your mind, in your spirit, in your goal, and honor what it is that you want. And the more you do it, the more you move towards that creative spiritual center of who you are, the better your life will continue to become. So I want to leave you with that tonight. I want to say thank you to each and every one of you for tuning in and being with us live on the call tonight. Those of you who are accessing this recording or catching it on YouTube or somewhere, I want to invite you to reach out and connect. Just be a part of this community. Get yourself involved in this. I want you to win in such a big way. I want you to experience what this has done for me, and I want you to meet these people. Everyone here tapped into my community are just as nice as you, and we are, you know, living our life, positively impacting our families and communities and the people around us. And it's not all about private jets and luxury mansions. It's about being comfortable and really living how you want to live. And I'm going to teach you how to do that and how to do it in greater ways, in more purposeful ways, so you can live a purposeful, productive, profitable, abundant life, because that is actually the way it is meant to be. So I want to thank you once again for being here. I want to encourage you to make a decision and act on it. You know, be a part of this next group of people that are going to come into this community at varying levels and study in greater ways to produce even better results. And I can't wait to be working with you again in the form and shape that that looks like. If there is anything that I can help you with, if you have any questions, my diary is open. I'm around all day today. You can get my mobile number from somebody. Give me a call. I'll be happy to have a chat and really move forward with your paradigm shift study. So thank you so much for being here and have a beautiful evening. I'm Karen Brook. Good night, everyone. Bye.